So thank you so much for joining, and welcome to this 45-minute restorative flow. So we will be ending around 9:15, and I wanted to start by sharing what restorative yoga is and why it's so important, especially in what's going on right now in the world. We are being invited to slow down, to tap into ourselves, our bodies, to adjust our pace and our practices in order to create a shift within and within the world. And restorative yoga has been something that has been one of those things for me where I practice here and there, maybe once a week. And in this time, I have found it to be such a blessing to have the space to move into this practice, to lean into it so much more often. And it's such a crucial part of our practice. So there's a quote that I love that says, "The goal of yoga is to create space where you were once stuck, to unveil layers of protection that you have built around your heart, to appreciate your body and become aware of the mind and the noises it creates, to make peace with who you are. The goal is to love you." So once you begin to shift your focus and your heart, your practice will grow. Once you begin to balance out that physical asana, maybe vinyasa or power yoga practice with yin or restorative, you will see how it all connects and builds a wholesome, deep connected practice all in all. So yoga really begins with listening. It's about self-acceptance, not self-improvement. And this practice speaks to that so strongly. So some of the benefits of restorative practice, when I offer a new type of movement or one that people don't typically practice, I always like to give a little background and the why and the how behind what we're doing. So it helps us discover where we are holding tension in the body and the mind. It enhances flexibility. It deeply relaxes the body and stills the mind by cultivating the skill of conscious relaxation. I love that. Cultivating the skill of conscious relaxation. It boosts our immune system, balances the nervous system, improves balance, develops compassion and understanding towards others and ourselves. Deeply heals. So while restorative yoga is a healing practice, it is not just a physical recovery practice. And yeah, with that said, I'll break down how the practice is going to go tonight. So we're going to warm up a bit, take a moment to get settled into our space and move our bodies so we can clear out any residual energy that is within us from the day. Then we are going to move through a few different restorative poses. We will need some props. So I invite you to have three pillows, two thicker pillows, and then one, I use a tiny, like a head pillow, but you can have a normal pillow, but three pillows as thick as you can get. So maybe those are couch pillows, bed pillows are totally fine. And then two blankets. So I'll give you a moment to get those props. All right. And then we'll move through the poses. We hold the poses for a few minutes each. So this really fosters and guides our bodies into deep relaxation. And then at the beginning of each posture, I will share a quote as a guide to something to lightly contemplate in the posture. And I will start this session with a quote, a very lighthearted quote. They're all not like this, but it is from Forgetting Sarah Marshall, one of my favorite movies. And Paul Rudd in it says, "The less you do, the more you do." And that is just perfect for restorative yoga. So keep that in mind. The less you do, the more you do. All right, let's go ahead and get started. So placing your props off to the side for now, your mountain of pillows and blankets. Begin to find an easy seat. Close your eyes and settle into your space. Take your time here. Begin to let go of what happened in your day. Let go of what was. And while we have faith in what the future will be and what will be, let go of the future that has not happened yet and will not happen right now. Begin to move deeply into what is, into this very present moment. Settling in to this portion of your day, into your evening. Taking a moment to honor that shift. Practice with three deep breaths. Inhale, breathe in through the nose. Fill up the body with breath. Hold at the top. And exhale it out the mouth. Let go. Inhale, breathe in. Fill up. Expand the body. And exhale, release. Let go of the breath, any stale air or energy. Inhale, breathe in lightness, softness, love and joy. And exhale, release anything you do not need for this deeply restorative practice. Bring your hands to heart center. And if you would like, set an intention for your practice. Inhale, breathe that intention in. And exhale, release the air. Breathe out soft in the muscles. Gently flutter the eyes open. Inhale, reach the prayer up to the sky. Lengthen through the side body. Good. Grow tall in the spine. Breathe here for a moment. You can keep your hands in prayer. We begin to interlace the fingers and turn the palms towards the sky. Find a deep rooted connection in the sit bones. Gently tuck your pelvis and move your belly button towards your spine. Engage the abs a bit. Reach up, energize through the arms and the fingertips. Lift the earlobes away from the shoulders to lengthen through the neck. Take one more inhale here and exhale your hands over to the right. Inhale back to center and exhale to the left. One more time on each side. Center, right, press into that left seat. Center, left, press into that right seat. Hands back to center, lift up, breathe in one more time. And exhale, float your hands in front of you and come on to all fours. Washing through a few rounds of cat and cow or any other movement that feels good here. So placing your hands and your knees on the ground and then either swaying the hips. Of course, my shawl here is in the way, but swaying the hips from side to side, rolling out the head, rotating through the shoulders. Or if you want to move through more traditional cat and cows, inhaling to cow, drop the belly, arch the spine. And exhaling cat, round the spine, lift through the core. Moving through a few more options, whatever feels good for you, closing your eyes, just moving the energy through your body. For a few more breaths, really tap in, tune in. Inhale, lift up onto the shins, reach the arms up towards the sky. And exhale, sit seat to heels, round and give yourself a hug. Two more like that. Inhale to reach. Exhale to round. Last one, inhale to reach. And exhale, round, sit on your heels. And then go ahead and place your hands back on the mat, come onto all fours. And rise up to your shins and go ahead and grab your props. We're gonna set up for our first pose, which is a restorative child's pose. So taking your two pillows, and of course at any point in this practice, if you wanna add more props to bring the ground up towards your body, or for any additional comfort anywhere you may choose, you wanna put a blanket underneath your knees or even draped over your shoulders, any way to make yourself more relaxed and deeply supported. So go ahead and take your at least two pillows out in front of you. You bring your knees to the outer edges of your mat and your toes together to touch behind you, just like we're setting up for a standard child's pose. You're going to bring the pillows in towards you. If your pillows are square or rectangle, you can put it on a diagonal or bring the shorter edge in towards your body. So they're right up against you as snug as they can be. And then go ahead and drape your torso over the pillows, arms out long in front of you, and just melt. Again, if you want to take an additional pillow and bring it up to your face, however feels good for you here. Settling in to this posture. Begin to let go. Even with this current situation that we're in right now in the world, where we have this time and space, we're at home, we are programmed to remain so busy, to constantly fill our schedule with task after task, thing after thing, when right now we're really being asked to slow down. But somehow we attach this feeling of shame or guilt to letting go, to being okay with doing nothing. So right here, right now, you have nowhere else to be. You are here, you are held in this shape, supported by the props, by gravity, by Mother Earth, by the energy of your space. Drink this in, this delicious, deep relaxation. Breathe, be, and let go. And in this first pose, the quote I would like to share is actually a mantra. So of course the breath is the anchor to the practice, and the mind starts to wander. A deep cleansing breath is the best thing we can do to bring us back to the present moment, back to our body, and back to our practice. The breath is the connection between the mind and the physical body. And with that said, sometimes we're a bit more distracted than others, and the breath isn't quite enough. So with that, I offer you to breathe with a mantra. Inhaling, I am. Exhaling, letting go. Where can you let go? Where can you soften just a little bit more? If you would like, go ahead and switch your cheeks. So lift your head up a bit slowly. Rotate your head and place the opposite cheek back down on the pillow or prop. Every inhale to bring breath, oxygen, nourishment into the body, to expand the body with breath, to cleanse the body with breath. And every exhale, to let go, to soften, to release any held tension, any held energy, any held effort that's in your shape. Unhinge the jaw, allow the tongue to melt off the roof of the mouth and behind the bottom tooth. Release all the micro muscles in the face. Let go. Taking five more deep breaths in this child's pose. Inhale. Exhale. One. Breathe in. Fill up, feel light. Let it go. Soften, melt. Two. Inhale deeply, fully, completely. Exhale. Release. Three. Breathe in. Fill up. Exhale. Deflate. Four. Last breath. Breathe in deep. Exhale. Let it go. Gently lift your head up. Bring your chin to center. Hold here for a moment. And then roll up through a rounded spine. Head is the last thing to come up. Pausing here for a moment, closing your eyes, sitting on your shins. Just take that in. Inhale deeply. Exhale, let it go. Open your eyes and begin to place one pillow out on each side of your mat. You're going to sit up and off of your heels, swing your legs out in front of you. Go ahead and give them a shake. Bend your knees, place your feet onto the mat. We're headed into a supported reclined butterfly pose. So if you want to take one blanket, place it behind you for a little bit of support when you lie down. If you want to take that third pillow and place it underneath the heart space, or that second blanket and fold it up nice and thick and place it under the heart space, if you want a bit of lift in the chest and openness in the heart here, you can do so now. And then go ahead and place the soles of your feet together. Your knees fall out one to each direction and they should be supported by each pillow underneath you. So in restorative yoga, we want to be fully supported by our props. We don't want to feel any type of sensation, even if it's a comfortable one. And then go ahead and recline down, draping over your blankets and your props. Your arms fall out to either side of you, palms facing up. Close your eyes. And once again, begin to melt into this shape. Finding your body, finding your breath here. Allow yourself to be held by your props. Release any effort. When the world moves too fast, you lose yourself in the chaos. Introduce yourself to each color of the sunset. Reacquaint with the earth beneath your feet. Thank the air that surrounds you with every breath. Find yourself in the appreciation of life. So with that, stillness and silence, I guided pretty much through the entirety of the last pose. So here, let go, melt, be, and breathe, and my voice will come back to guide you out. Taking five more deep breaths in this pose. Inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale deeply. Exhale fully. Two, three more on your own. When you're ready, bringing your knees in towards each other to center, placing your feet on the mat, lifting up to sit and removing any props behind you if they're there. If not, you can stay on the ground. If you removed your props, gently lowering yourself back down to the ground slowly. Walking your heels in towards your body so you can reach them with your fingertips when you extend your arms out straight. Feet are hip-width distance apart, and you're going to take your two pillows and have them nearby. We're moving into restorative bridge. So inhale, lifting the hips up towards the sky, and then beginning to move the pillows underneath your sacrum space. So maybe one pillow is perfect here for you. Go ahead and try that out. If you would like another pillow, lift the hips. You may not need to come onto the balls of your feet. And then go ahead and scooch that additional pillow underneath your sacrum space. And then go ahead and melt the sacrum, the low back, onto the props, adjusting where you need. Hands come out long. Palms facing up, eyes closed. Begin to feel the heaviness of the feet, of the hips, of the lower back, of the back of the head. Breathing here. We'll be here for about 3 minutes. Where can you let go? Where can you release? Maybe taking note from the seat of the observer with no judgment, no need to place negative or positive on your thoughts. Simply be curious to where your mind goes, where your energy goes, when your body is still. And the quote I'll share for this pose is, when you reach your edge, soften, soften until you slip through the constraints and can create a new rhythm, a new route, a new release. So this quote makes me think of water, the flow of water. How it's so fluid and free. It can go through, up, down, around. It can take any shape or form. So think of yourself here, maybe as water, or a melting snowman, or a really overcooked noodle, anything that's soft and free, anything without structure, alignment, constraint, or boundary. Feel the softness and the freedom. When you reach your edge, soften. Taking five more breaths here, maybe coming back to that mantra. Breathing in, I am. Breathing out, letting go. Feel those words. Feel them to be true. When you're ready, gently lifting your hips up towards the sky, removing any props out from under you, and then rolling through a rounded spine, lowering down towards the earth, vertebrae by vertebrae. Sacrum is the last thing to hit. Moving the legs out long and straight, and lying down flat on the ground, resetting the spine. Finding a heaviness in the back body, a heaviness of the heels, of the seat, the shoulders, the back of the head. And with this heaviness in the back body, with this anchor of back body to earth, bring your awareness to your front body. Begin to feel the lightness, the openness, the softness of the front body in response to the heaviness of your back body on the earth beneath you. Feeling these oppositional energies working in harmony, grounded and open. The energy of the earth holding you closely as you surrender your shape to gravity. And the energy of the air, of the sky, opening your heart and your mind. You
your next inhale, float your knees up and in towards your body. And then wrap your shins with your forearm and gently roll from side to side, releasing the sacrum. Good. Place your feet back down on the mat and then walk the outer edges of your feet to the outer edges of your mat and allow your knees to fall in towards each other in center. Breathing here. Stay here, or you can gently windshield wiper the legs from side to side. Can you let your legs move you instead of you moving your legs? Release the effort. And bringing the knees back to center and lift them up and in towards your body. And then we're gently going to lift up to a seated position. So this next posture, going to use the wall, or if you have a couch. I'm going to show you on the couch, but you're more than welcome to use a wall. So taking a pillow or two. If you're on the couch, I would say one pillow. On the wall, I would say two. Placing the pillows right at the edge of the couch or the wall. And then invitation again to grab one of your blankets and place it behind the pillows for a bit more support and cushion. You're going to do the same thing whether you're couch or wall. So you're going to scooch your seat right to the edge of the pillows on one side. And then you're going to roll down on the pillow and then twist over. So your back and your sacrum is on the pillow and your legs are right up against the couch or the wall. You're going to lie back down towards the earth. Again, option for that second blanket or pillow to come underneath your head space to elevate the head a bit. If you're on the couch, let your legs hang. If you're on the wall, lengthen your legs up and allow your heels to rest on the wall. And if you're on the couch and you'd rather have your legs lifted, you can just lift them up and let them hang in space without a wall. It's a bit more of a yin option, as we do have held sensation and energy in this shape. That is okay. If you want to take the full restorative, definitely let your legs come down on the couch. Setting up for ultimate comfort, relaxation, and ease. Close your eyes. Tap back into the breath, maybe back into that mantra. Again, we'll be here for 3 minutes. The quote I would like to share is, the quieter you become, the more you are able to hear. Listen. Listen to your body. Listen to your subtle energy as it ripples through your being. Listen to the stillness.
listen to your heartbeat. Listen to the music. Listen to the rhythm of slowing down. Taking five more deep breaths. And gently, when you're ready, slowly lowering your legs down the wall if they're on the wall by bending the knees and bringing the knees to the chest. If they're on the couch, go ahead, just move the knees to the chest until the feet come off the couch. Either way, rolling over to one side, off of the props, off of the pillows. And then gently pressing yourself up to a seated position. Coming back to your mat. Placing a blanket along behind you. Sitting down at the edge of the blanket. We're going to use one pillow for this practice. These next two poses. So we're going to move into really easy supported supine twists. So have your one pillow, and of course, again, any other props that you want to bring in to make you feel more supported and comfortable, that is on you. Slowly lie down onto the blanket behind you. Bring your knees to your chest, and then
And maybe you want that second blanket by the side. We're going to go to the right first, so by that right side. So when your legs fall over, they're supported by softness and a plush blanket. So go ahead now and begin to let your knees fall to the right. Maybe there's a blanket underneath that right leg. And when they get there, go ahead and open the left leg up towards the sky. Take that plush pillow, bring it in between the knees, and then go ahead and place that left knee back down on the ground. Twist your torso back to center, cactus your or T your arms, and then move the gaze and turn the head to the left. Finding the subtle, accessible, and extremely beneficial spinal twist on the right side. Close the eyes. Begin to soften into this shape. Every inhale to send a luxurious breath through the body. And every exhale to let go, to release just a little more. The quote for this posture is, through stillness we grow. Through individual growth, community develops. A human being is part of a whole, called by us the universe. So when we take the time to move slowly, to tap in to the pure essence of our being without distraction, without so much to do, and we sit in the now, in the being, we start to grow in the most authentic and pure way. This is how we best show up for the people in our lives, for our community at large, and most importantly, for ourselves. Finding these moments of pure restoration, of deep relaxation, and melting in to that feeling. Maybe again, simply taking note. How do you feel? How do you feel when you slow down? Gently bringing your knees back to center, remove the prop. If you have the blanket on the right side, go ahead and bring it to the left. Grab that pillow. Lift your knees up towards your body, and then allow them to fall up and over to the left. Lifting the right knee up and placing the pillow in between the thighs. Teeing or cactusing the arms, and then rotating the head and the gaze to the right. Close your eyes. And on this side, I will leave you to stillness, to complete quiet, to listen. And my voice will come back when we're ready to move on. breaths here. Breathe in, fill up. Exhale, release. Four more on your own. When you're ready, no rush. If you're still on your breath work, stay there. Beginning to lift your knees up to center, remove the prop. Place your feet back down on the mat. Walk the outer edges of the feet to the outer edges of the mat. Go ahead and let the knees fall in. And just like we did last time, stay here. Begin to windshield wiper the legs from side to side for a bit deeper of a release. Bringing your knees back to center, giving yourself a little squeeze, gentle, about 25%. And then rolling over to one side and gently lifting up to a seated position so we can set up for a restorative supported shavasana. So we're going to be using pretty much all of our props here. This is one of my favorite ways to close out a restorative practice. So go ahead and take the thicker blanket of the two, if one is thicker. Fold it up so it's in a hamper. Back to elementary school, a hamburger shape, so one side is longer than the other. Lie it down flat, and then begin to roll the blanket into a really thick tube. Placing that tube on the mat behind you, we're going to recline back. Our spine's going to drape over this tube. Taking your two pillows, your two really thick pillows, and bringing them near. Having the other pillow in the blanket, also near and available. We're going to sit. So the sacrum, the low back, is right up against the edge of this thick noodle tube. Spread the legs wide. Place the feet on the mat. Go ahead and bring your both of those stacked two pillows in between your legs. Then lift one leg up and then the other. Scooch the pillows in towards your seat so they're nice and secure and you're nice and supported. Grab the other pillow and the other blanket and go ahead and recline back so your spine is completely aligned. Supported by the tube feels really good. If your tube is long enough, you can roll the edge of it so it comes right underneath your neck space, and that can hold you up, your head up in this pose. If not, you can go ahead and take that third pillow and place it behind your head and on top of the tube. And take your last blanket and go ahead and drape it over your body. Could stay here forever. Close your eyes. Drape your arms down beside you, palms facing up. And begin to feel this shape take over your body. Feel the lift of the heart. Feel the head completely supported and resting on the pillow or the blanket behind you. Feel the spine as it's draped over the blanket that's in a tube underneath you. Feel your shoulders melt down towards the earth as they pour over the tube-like shape. Feel the response of a broadened collarbone, open chest, soft belly. Come back to this feeling of a heaviness in your bottom half. The legs are heavy and held, releasing any effort. Maybe your knees and your toes fall out to the sides, to the outer edges of the pillows and the mat. Unhinge the jaw. Tongue nestles behind bottom teeth. Soft in the space between the eyebrows. Feel as though every muscle in your body is melting away from the bones. Feel a relief and a deep release. You are safe, you are held, you are supported and comforted by the space of your own home, the props underneath you, and the warmth of your own energy. Melt into this. Be and breathe. And my voice will come back to guide you out. Take a deep inhale. Exhale. Begin to wiggle your fingers and your toes, bringing subtle movement back to the physical body. When you're ready, no rush. If you want to stay in this supported shavasana, stay. If you're ready to move out, go ahead and bring your right knee in towards your chest and then your left. Roll over to one side. Come off of the props. Stay here in this fetal position for just a moment. And then gently, slowly, with your eyes closed, press yourself up to a seat. Maybe bringing that blanket, keeping it on your lap or wrapped around you. Allow your hands to rest on your thighs. Stay with this softness in the body, but find just a slight lengthening of the spine, lift of the heart. Taking a moment to note, recognize, observe any shifts
mind, the energy, the perspective. Without judgment, recognizing what this practice was like for you. What came up in your mind and in your heart when you stilled your body? Inhaling, I am. Exhaling, letting go. Let go.